Identity is a tricky, tricky business. You think you're somebody till suddenly...
Yes, hello. Gerry McIntyre here. Welcome to UNSUNG. I've been busy. I've been away for a while doing shows and being very blessed. My guest tonight is E. Clayton Cornelious, and we've known each other for a very long time. We did Five Guys Named Mo at the Lyric in Oklahoma a minute ago, and he's here tonight. He's a performer. He's like in Angel Proud right now. He's done beautiful Wonderland, Scottsboro Boys, Chorus Line, Music Man, Lion King, and Cat and the Kings, which I have no idea what that is, but I'll ask him later. And he's here tonight, and he's one of the producers of Chicken Biscuits. And he's a Black man. And I have never experienced a Black producer on Broadway, and I've been here since 1985. So ladies and gentlemen, here's E. Clayton Cornelious. Hello, E. Clayton Cornelious. It's been a minute.
It has, like a lot of minutes. It's been a lot of minutes.
Oh my God. Congratulations on everything. I'm going to tell the people, we did a show together in Oklahoma in 1900.
Yes, exactly. Thank you.
See, it was so long ago. I mean, I don't really remember because I didn't have a good time. You remember?
You didn't?
Well, I had a good time with you guys, but it was a lot of work. And I was like, going, wait a minute.
It was. But you pulled it off. You did a very good job. I learned. I got a trip from you on that show.
Oh, well, that's good to hear.
Yes. You were teaching the kids.
Oh, my God. But you know, that thing about it is like you say yes to things and then you're like, oh, this is really hard.
Right. But listen, I learned some good comedic tricks from you on that one. And it was that give it, like stop, oh no, but give that, yeah. That thing.
Sweet, yeah. That's my trademark.
Honey, that was trademark right there. I was like, I need to learn that Gerry McIntyre trademark. I pull it out when needed, but you know, I pay homage to you if I use it.
All right, I'm glad. Okay. As right. Long as you say, I learned it from me.
I learned it from Gerry McIntyre.
What? Okay, we have been trying to get together for so long, but I'm busy and you're more busy.
Well, I wouldn't say more, but I am busy. I am a busy boy.
That's okay. So tell me what's going on right now, what's in your life right now, like today.
Right now, I am gearing up for my lead producer debut on Chicken and Biscuits, the Broadway play.
Yes.
Family comedy at Circle in the Square this Sunday, October 10th, this weekend. And I'm doing a little bit of double dutying because I'm going back into my Broadway show as an actor on Ain't Too Proud on Broadway. So I'm actually opening that show a week later. And so I'm in rehearsals from 10 to 6. And then sometimes I go to the show to see Chicken and Biscuits, or I'm constantly on the phone talking to investors and in meetings and stuff like that, and doing the whole do this, you know, throughout my time in rehearsal. And then thank God we finally open, and then I'll be in tech rehearsals for Ain't Too Proud, and then I finally open that one, and then I could have a little bit of peace in my life.
Oh my God. Oh yeah. My God. So what are you doing on Ain't Too Proud? Just tell the people what you're doing on Ain't Too Proud.
I play the character of Richard Street, and I play 8 different characters in the show.
Yeah.
And then I play a temptation in the second act, but in the first act, I do a lot of different characters and bits and things. I do a lot of Gerry McIntyre, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. When bits. I saw this, I was like this, you better come on, be everywhere.
Right? And I'm grateful to be a part of that show. It's a wonderful show. If you haven't seen it, come and see it. It's fantastic. It's about the Temptations and their real life story. This is Dominique Morisseau, who is the writer on Ain't Too Proud, and she is amazing. She tells the truth, and it's just amazing. It's an amazing, amazing show. If you don't like musical theater, then you're gonna love this show because it's about the truth.
Wow. I mean, I loved it. And those steps, hon.
Oh.
There's a lot of steps.
Yes, and my old self was getting really tired of all the steps. But I'm keeping up with the kids. I'm keeping up. I hold my own. Tony Award-winning choreography. That's what I'm talking about.
I'm not playing. When I saw it, I was like, okay, Sergio, come on, fantastic.
Sergio and his assistant Edgar did his job on that.
Right.
Yeah.
Tell me how it felt. Tell me how it felt after being in, what, 18 months or something, not doing a show and then coming back to rehearsal. Tell me how that went.
You know what? It's funny. You know James Harkness as well, right? Yes. Uh-huh. So James is in my show. And, you know, we're the older gentlemen in our show. And we both said that we didn't mind the pandemic. It was an opportunity because we are so busy sometimes on Broadway, as you know, going from one thing to the next or just doing a lot of projects, that it was an opportunity for me to stop and to find like rest, you know?
Yeah.
There's peace and stillness, or there's, you know, there's a lot of work to do when you're still, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And thinking about things and devoting time to family, devoting time to myself, projects I never got to do, I did. Right. I started my website on the pandemic. In my 25-year career, I never had a website. So I was like, it's time to do the website.
Right.
I got things done in my home. I did, I went back to school. I'm in business school right now. I'm getting a business degree in business management with a focus on entrepreneurship. And a lot of all these things kind of came out of the pandemic.
Right.
And I've been talking to my university about, you know, getting my honorary degree from Point Park University, and just all these wonderful things are just coming out of the pandemic. And I just believe, you know, it was the opportunity for us to take advantage of it, or sometimes other people just sort of did nothing, you know, which is okay too. But I thought it was an opportunity to work on me, on myself.
Well, that's amazing. I didn't know you went to Point Park.
What'd you say?
I didn't know you went to Point Park.
I'm from Pittsburgh originally.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I don't think I ever knew that, because I did, this summer I did the Wizard of Oz there, you know, in Heinz Field.
Oh, okay.
Which was crazy, you know.
So for Point Park University?
No, it's for Pittsburgh CLO.
Oh, okay.
So all those Pittsburgh people I know, so, well, I didn't know you're a Pittsburgh person.
Yeah.
Okay, we have to talk about that. That's going to be a sidebar.
Yeah, that's going to be, yeah, exactly.
Oh my God. Okay, so now you did, you did Beautiful. You did Wonderland. You did Scottsboro Boys, Chorus Line.
Music Man Revival.
Yeah.
And my first show, Cat and the Kings.
I don't know that show.
Cat and the Kings was a South African show that went via London, won all these Olivier Awards, and then came to Broadway.
Okay.
And I was standby for three of the guys. It was only a 6-person show. And it was my first show on Broadway.
Wow.
And it was amazing to be with them. I'm still friends with them. I definitely want to go back to South Africa and visit. We stay in contact. But yeah, that was my first show. Second show was Music Man. Third show was... I think The Lion King. I've done, let's just say I've done eight Broadway shows and 8 national tours.
Right.
Almost all back to back, throwing a couple of TV spots and commercials in that time. And I worked on the West End of London and, you know, just kind of worked constantly.
And you're only 25. It's amazing.
I know, my skin regiment, right? It wasn't until 4 years ago where I kind of got interested, I think, where I just started doing Broadway investing and then producing.
I don't know. I don't understand. Tell me that story, because, you know, I like a good backstory, because literally when I had Douglas Lyons on the on another show that I do called In the Pipe. And so it's like, you know, for new musicals.
Right.
So we did his new musical, Moon and Stars, which is fantastic, which is
okay.
And then I had talked to Liz Larson, you know, Liz Larson.
Yes, I do. I love that one.
And so she said to me, she said, oh, you're interviewing Douglas? And I said, yeah. This new musical, Moon and Stars. He's like, did he tell you about Chicken and Biscuits? That's going to the Circle Square. I was like, no, but I'll ask him. And then when we got on Zoom, I asked him about it. And Douglas was like, I don't know what you're talking about. I was like, oh, okay. Because I was almost like, I thought I was being gaslit. Gaslit? Yeah, I thought it was gaslit.
Was it before we announced or something?
Yes, it was before you announced. It was before all the stuff. But I'm like, wait a minute, how does Liz Larson know?
And I right. But well, you know, she's been the beautiful family. So me and Doug were in the dressing room. You know, we were fellow original cast members of Beautiful together. Yeah. And we sat right next to each other, and we always had this dream of him riding away right next to me, all these plays and musicals that he was doing. And I had this dream of always wanting to be, you know, an investor or producer on shows. And then 8 years later, boom, I'm a lead producer on this show he wrote, Chicken and Biscuits, which is, you know, debuting on Broadway, you know, at Circle in the Square. So it's like, you know, they always talk about Black girl magic, Black boy magic, you know?
Yeah. I mean, what was the thing? What was the impetus that you're like, you know what? I want to, instead of singing and dancing and acting, I want to be in charge. I want to make more money. Tell me, what was the impetus for you to do this?
I mean, I think it kind of starts, you know how it is. Like I'm always the deputy in shows and I always sort of took the lead in putting stuff together or helping people out, or you know, when I was on tour, I would always produce the BCFA sort of shows and cabarets and things of that nature. And I started to realize that I had a knack at putting shows together, putting, you know, running every aspect of things and being sort of very well organized. I'm very well organized in my life. And my dad's a big business guy. So I kind of took after him in that, you know, way. And then I was doing the Chorus Line revival, and I called up the marketing and asked them if they were interested in having a sponsor on the show other than Mac. My boyfriend at the time worked for like L'Oreal or something like that. And we kind of had this idea of them sort of being sponsors on the show. And I opened up an LLC and did all these things and, you know, tried to make that happen. And, you know, that went well. And then I kind of closed it off, but my LLC, I just kept it active, but I didn't do anything else with it. And years later, I incorporated myself, and then I stepped into the rehearsal room for Ain't Too Proud. And after being a part of that cast and seeing what was there, I was like, I definitely have to be on this. And I got in the back door of that show, investing. And now I invest in Ain't Too Proud, Hadestown, MJ the Musical that's coming, Carolina Change. And I do both tours of the Hadestown tour and the Ain't Too Proud tour as well. So I have 6 Broadway investments right now. Plus I started co-producing with my business partner, who I met on the first national tour of Lion King, Pamela Ross. She lives in Vegas. And we always had this dream of like investing and producing together. And we started a production company and we started co-producing, investing together and then co-producing. And then we just found ourselves in this lead producing spot and we're learning a lot and it's very new. And I'm just grateful to sort of be here learning and being in this position, you know, as Black producers, future Black producers, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
I when I was thinking about talking to you today, I was like, going, you know what? I have never had a Black producer walk into a room of a rehearsal room, you know, like the meet and greet. I've never, you know, and I've been doing this, my first Broadway show was 1985 or something. So, you know what I mean? I've been doing this a long time and I've never, it's just wild to me that I've never had a Black producer ever walk in.
Yeah.
And that, yeah. I just, it's just wild. And so I'm so proud of you. That's so amazing. And you,
Thank you. So did
someone take you on the journey? Did someone say like, okay, this is how you do it? Or you, how did you?
You know, I did figure out a lot of stuff on my own. You know, there's a lot of life lessons in just experience. And I'm a kind of person that throws myself into experiences just so I can learn, you know, from the raw experience of something. But, you know, I did have, you know, a few mentors. You know, right now my mentor would be Hunter Arnold, who is, you know, he's sort of like, you know, one of our lead producers or experienced producers on Chicken and Biscuits. And, you know, he's pretty much the catalyst that made all of this happen so fast, going to Circle and Square and going to Broadway. So, I'm learning a lot through him, through his team. And I'm on the team as a general partner. So it's great to learn from the inside out, you know. You know, it's not easy. It's difficult. And I know that. And I'm learning every day. And, you know, hopefully that I will continue to, I have a lot of projects coming up. You know, I've been around the industry and in the producing investing world long enough to accrue colleagues and friends. And now I have two other projects in queue, you know, Mandela the Musical that's coming up and Tommy Revival that's coming up. And I'm involved in the producing part of that. So, you know, it's wonderful that I can now do this, and I hope to be the change for Broadway for the future. You know what I mean? I hope to be one of those, I hope to be a Black producer stepping into a room and changing up the game, you know?
Yeah, because do you find it hard? Do you, or you just walk in the room and you're like, this is what I know, I'm confident and I'm gonna do this? Or do you find anybody like, I don't know, you know, because to me, it's like it's new. This is
new. And you know what? There's just how we've been learning over these 2 years of Black Lives Matter and you know, the presidency and everything that's been going on, you know, there is definitely challenges, you know, even deep within all these offices and going through this whole Broadway journey, especially as a producer, being a Black producer, there's challenges. Yeah. And, you know, you overcome those challenges and you try to fight through those challenges. But the one thing I will say is that, you know, something I just actually taught at Point Park University a few weeks ago, and I spoke to the whole theater body there. And they asked me a similar question to that. And I said, you know what? Step in every room like you belong. I step in every room like I am supposed to be here, you know? Because there's a reason how I got to this point. You know, I don't necessarily how I got here, but I'm here and my name is on that playbill and I worked hard to get there. So I'm gonna step in every situation as if I belong.
Yeah.
And worry about everything else after that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so gorgeous. I mean, you know Randy Donaldson. So, but Randy was like, I just know Randy was doing a working on Scottsboro Boys, and he was saying to me that it was just hard, and I was like, because that was a while ago. So I mean, I'm so glad that you have no fear to walk into a room.
I mean, listen, you know, I'm old enough at this point, and especially what I've seen in the last 2 years, we now know that life is way too precious and time is of the essence. And I'm not going to be scared anymore. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't, sometimes we might not know what we're doing, but if we walk in faith, that's just my faith. If we walk in faith, God's going to do the rest. So I literally just go. We nothing can move in our lives unless we move first.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Nothing's going to happen for us unless we move first. So yes. I just move that I'm going to, you know, do the good, you know, do the right thing, be step into the situation, step into my blessings. And I usually do. And if I ever fail at something, I pick myself up and I try again, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so, I mean, I've had this, like, since, you know, even the pandemic started, I got to, you know, do Godspell and do all these other shows, and I didn't even collect unemployment. So I've been so fortunate.
Right.
You have collect unemployment and just all get all these gifts.
Mm-hmm.
And then you kind of be like, wait a minute now. I get anxious because I think it's all going to go away in the day. That's my thing that I'm working on. It's like, it's here and it's present and you deserve it.
You deserve it. Everything that you're getting, you deserve. Mm-hmm. I think sometimes we get so down on ourselves about things. It's like, look where you are now. Be grateful for what you have and then step into these blessings, and you deserve everything. Everybody deserves everything they want. You just have to move into it. You know what I mean?
And yeah. I feel that's the thing that the pandemic taught me. It was like, because it was like, well, why are you working? I'm like, well, because I am. And I just kept moving. There was no questions. I didn't question. Yeah. Usually yeah. question. Okay. But there's no questions. Like, you want to work? I was like, absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, imagine if you would have talked yourself out of something. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's easy to do.
It is so easy to do. Now, tell the story, the plot of Chicken and Biscuits for the people.
Oh, Lord. well, Chicken and Biscuits is set at a Black church, a Black funeral. The patriarch of the family has died. And, you know, families get together sometimes for events. It's either a wedding or a funeral, and we don't sometimes see the whole family until these events happen, you know what I mean? Until someone passes away. So it's just about the messiness of family and a family coming together for the first time in a long time, seeing each other and still dealing with their issues, you know? And it's just wonderful. It's just, you're gonna laugh, you're gonna cry. Touching. It's something we need right now out of the pandemic. It's a comedy. I mean, it's like a fly on the wall at a Black funeral. You know what I mean? And a family coming together and dealing with issues that everybody else deals with. You know what I mean? So even though it's an African American family, it's a universal story, and anybody can connect to it. You know?
Yes. Okay.
And that's why it's sort of like on fire right now, you know? That's why it's on fire right now. Everyone is like raving about it, and I'm getting messages, sweet messages from everybody saying they love the show. They just laughed, they cried, and they just, thank you so much for putting this out there. And you know, it's what we need after a pandemic, and it's incredible that people are responding so well.
Chicken and Biscuits, the new Broadway comedy about a woman who wants a peaceful funeral for daddy when, oh no. Here comes her party girl sister dressed to show God what she's blessed with. Oh no, here comes a nosy niece stirring the pot again. Oh no, here comes her son Kenny, fabulous as he wants to be. Oh no, he is not bringing his boyfriend, a white boy, and oh no, oh yes. It's Chicken and Biscuits, the new Broadway play full of love, a little shade, and really good dish.
So how is it, how is it in the theater? Is it, because you're in previews now, so how is it, like, how's the audience response? Is it like, is it universal? Is it, you know,
It really is. You know what's funny? You know, there's gospel music playing in the theater when you walk in.
Yeah.
to get you sort of like in that atmosphere. And yeah. you just see people clapping along and singing along. And we actually have people shouting and going up and down the stairs. And, yeah, and it's a fun show. And you get to see other cultures celebrate in that. You know, yeah. they want to be a part of that, and they're right there with them, you know. And luckily, we do have, it's a largely Black cast, but we have Michael Urie, who plays sort of the boyfriend of the son. And he's Jewish, and he's meeting this Black family for the first time. So he's sort of like the connection for the other cultures, because he doesn't know what's going on. They don't know. You know, I mean, they're seeing it through his eyes, you know.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I cannot wait to see
it's a wonderful cast. It's cast so wonderfully. So
you know I've known Norm Lewis since the beginning of time.
Yes, he's doing well.
And I love too? It's like I know Cleo King.
Yes, when Cleo King
was in my first New York show that I did.
Wow.
And, you know, then she's, you know, just doing all of this stuff. We did Godspell together with Glenn Cassell. I know Norm still from the beginning of time. So it was like, when I saw them, I was like, and they're doing a play.
Do you know,
you know how great that is for a musical?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about. We don't get to do play. We have to sing and dance.
Yes. I know that Norm said that he was, you know, a little hesitant, you know, at first, because this is his play debut. So he's loving it. He's loving it. And I'm glad he gets that opportunity. Cleo King, it's her Broadway debut. So it's just wonderful. There's 30 plus debuts in every department of our show. And we wanted to do that. I'm making my debut as a producer. A lot of people are making their acting debut. There's people making their designer debuts. Everybody on the design team is BIPOC. And they're making, every designer is making their debut, except for one, Dee Dee, who is a costume designer. She is a Tony nominated costume designer. So she has had her nomination. So, but there's a lot of debuts on the show, so.
That's amazing, my friend. I'm so proud of you. And thank you for changing the scenario, You know, when people talk about, they ask, you know, like, what could we do? It's like, well, the thing that we can do is, like, when you're in charge and have power to change it. Like, when I'm casting something and all the headshots are just white people or something, I'm like, I can't do it. You know what I mean? You have to talk about it. And I'm telling you the honest truth, that most of the people don't know. They're not doing anything malicious.
Right.
They're used to.
Right.
And then I'm like, let's put another picture in someone of color. Whatever the deal is, because when we have, and it's looking so good. I'm like, the Broadway now that's coming up is so interesting to me.
Yeah. It's a powerful moment. I mean, 7 Black new plays this fall coming up. And then, you know, Ain't Too Proud's coming back. You know, that's very, very Black as well. I try to be fair across the board. You know, for me, it's not really about skin color, it's about talent. You know what I mean? I want to put the most qualified person in that position. If it happens to be Black, great. If it happens to be white, okay. You know what I mean? But it's the most qualified person for that job. You know? Yeah.
You're absolutely right.
All I have to say then to people is go get vaccinated, go see a Broadway show, come see Ain't Too Proud. Come see Chicken and Biscuits, see all the Broadway musicals, but see mine first.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and just, you know, let's do this right. Let's mask up and let's get vaccinated and get back to life, you know?
Yeah, I do. The thing about it, that it's not that hard to me. You know, when you go to the theater, it's like, you know, you see the line, the vaccine, you're like, oh my God, all this stuff is like, ladies and gentlemen, it's not that hard. It takes literally 5 minutes to show your vaccination card and just move through the line. It's not that hard. Yeah. All right, my friend. I I can't even tell you how happy I am to see your face.
Oh, I know. I mean, I miss you already. Like, I'm already going back to the past of our shenanigans, but I miss you. Thank you so much to have me on the show, Mr. Living Legends. You're living legends.
Oh, come on. Listen, what do you think about a Wednesday matinee, chicken and biscuits, and then Agent Brown in the evening?
Exactly.
It's a long day of Clayton Cornelious, but I'm ready.
Yes.
All right, my friend.
All right.
Mwah. I adore you. I adore you. Adore you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. Really appreciate it. Yeah. Okay. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Okie dokie. How about that? How great was that? How great was that? Now, I just have to give you some York information, some York stuff. What do I call it? York stuff. Okay, Blue Roses is coming up Monday, October 18th. Then we have the Oscar Hammerstein Award Gala Monday, November 1st. And it's celebrating Richard Maltby Jr. and David Shire and also Elisa Stein, who's one of my favorite people in the world. Oh my God, I love her so much. Oh, I did enter laughing and met her. And she has just been so sweet to me. And I just adore her. That's going to be at the Edison Ballroom. Then we have Cheek to Cheek, November 24th to January 2nd. And I hope you know about our new home. And it's at the theater at St. Jean, like the Denim. And that's 150 East 76th Street. Okay. And if you want to donate, give us some money, we're welcome to take it. And that's at yourtheater.org, spelled the old-fashioned way, R-E. And I'm so glad to see you virtually, and I will see you soon. Yes, thank you very much. Have a great night.
Identity is a tricky, tricky business. You think you're somebody till suddenly you're not.